was able to study Bertrand Russell's How to Escape from Intellectual Rubbish. Okay, so this is the essay, How to Escape from Intellectual Rubbish by Bertrand Russell. I'm sharing the image of kickoff from Russell. Bertrand Russell, born in the year 1872 and died in the year 1917. He was the British mathematician and social critic. He is the most widely read philosopher of the last century. A philosophical genius, Russell's sharp and revealing wit has many a time tonsured exhibitions of social snobbery of the English society. So he was awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature in the year 1915. And in his essay, the famous essay, Marriage and Morals, which was published in the year 1929, he gave his outrageous views on sexual morality, causing an immediate uproar in the social circles of the time. And his major works include The History of Western Philosophy, The Principles of Mathematics, and The Problems of Philosophy. Bertrand Russell, his essay, How to Escape from Intellectual Rubbish. So this is what we are going to study today. So what is this intellectual rubbish first? Intellectual rubbish is nothing but the false belief that we all have. The false belief or beliefs or, you know, baseless opinions, or it could be even superstitions of various kinds. So all these are called intellectual rubbish. So intellectual rubbish means false beliefs that we have. So Russell in this essay states that human beings are prone to formulate foolish opinions. So that is intellectual rubbish. So human beings are prone to formulate foolish opinions at some point of their life, though it is not always. And he has given a few examples here. Russell has given few examples here that keep us away from foolish opinions and silly errors. And he says that the great Greek philosopher Aristotle, had committed a silly error. Okay, so Aristotle, he held that he had an opinion that women have fewer teeth than men. The Russell says that the great philosopher Aristotle, he could have avoided such a silly error by simply counting his wife's teeth. So that he could have simply asked his wife, that is Mrs. Aristotle, to keep her mouth open while he counted. So he could have avoided that silly error by counting his wife's teeth. Next, so many such matters are hardly brought to the test of experience. So if you have any doubt, if people have any doubt regarding such things, it's very easy to test it, but we never do that. So many matters are hardly brought to the test of experience. Indeed, it is difficult too. The main reason is we are too much obsessed with passionate convictions on such matters. So there are so many ways by which one can become aware of one's bias. See, if an opinion contrary to one's own makes one's own, it makes the person angry. So then the person must understand that they themselves are doubtful in the subconscious level. And Russell explains the difference between arithmetic and theology in this essay. Okay, he makes the difference between arithmetic and theology in this essay. How to escape from intellectual rubbish. So what is arithmetic? Arithmetic is about knowledge, isn't it? It's about the knowledge or experience. But if you say theology is only about opinions. Theology is only based on beliefs or opinion. So knowledge is the result of observations, but opinion need not be so. So knowledge is based on observations, but opinion need not be so. So whenever one gets angry about another person's opinion or beliefs, the person should be on his god or her god and make observations to ascertain their idea. So you have to find you have to find observations to prove that idea is from getting angry. So the main reason is we are too much obsessed with passionate convictions on such matters. So this is how we become biased. But there are ways to make ourselves aware of our bias. So he here gives us tips, Russell. He gives us tips how to make ourselves aware of those biases. The first thing is, he says, the first tip or the first suggestion that he gives is travel. So to become aware of the opinions held in social circles different from one's own or different from others, we must travel. Travel is a good way of reducing the intensity of insular prejudice. Okay, so the first thing is traveling. Here, Russell cites his personal experiences of traveling. So when he was young, he lived much outside his own country, especially in France, Germany, Italy and USA. So this traveling experience will definitely diminish many of our insular prejudices. So of course everyone cannot be a traveler, but everyone can easily choose to come across contrary opinions. Reflecting on them, one could conclude both parties may be right, but that cannot be wrong, we all know that. So this traveling helps us to understand the different opinion. And the second tip which Russell gives is social circle, that is conversation, communication. If one cannot afford travel, the next suggestion is they can communicate with people who have different opinions. So this communication or conversation will help one to think from the other's perspective. If a person cannot afford travel, the next suggestion is we can communicate with people who have different opinions. So this might help one to think from other's perspective. And the third tip or suggestion is reading. So if we cannot do the first one is travel, to travel. First suggestion, the first tip to avoid intellectual rubbish given by Bertrand Russell is to travel. And the second is to communicate with people. And the third one is reading. Otherwise, one can read a newspaper belonging to the opposite party. Okay, so not the newspaper which belongs to your party. You have to read a newspaper belonging to the opposite party. If such people and newspapers seem to be one have to caution oneself that they'll be seen in the same situation by others. Next, however, all these awareness of foreign customs need not be always beneficial. So he says all these need not be traveling, reading or communicating with people need not be always beneficial. Example that he gives is, in the Manchus conquered China, it was the custom among the Chinese that women to have small feet. And for the Manchus, the men to wear pigtails. These two, according to Russell, are foolish beliefs. Instead of these two people dropping their foolish customs, each adopted the custom of the other. So the Chinese continued wearing pigtails until the Manchus dominion ended in 1911. So one must, however, learn to judge and accept only what is good in other people and cultures. So this is very important. So we have to accept or we have to follow only the custom or the culture that is good to other people. Simply blind conformity to another faith or practice will not do any good. So this we must understand. And Russell's next tip to avoid intellectual rubbish is, this is the next tip, the third one. to imagine, he advises the readers to indulge in imaginary arguments with a person having different bias, so different opinions. So we have to imagine having conversation or argument with a person who has a different opinion. So the one and only advantage of the method is it is not subject to the limitations of time and space. So Russell says that he had changed his mind several times as a result of such kind of imaginary. So this is actually one simple way to escape from intellectual rubbish. So he says that Russell says that by engaging in imaginary arguments with an opponent, we can escape from this intellectual rubbish. So in this context, Russell refers to Mahatma Gandhi. Okay, Mahatma Gandhi deploring railways and the machinery. So this must have sounded absurd to the Westerner. But by engaging in an imaginary argument with the Mahatma, you may know why he deplored the railways and machinery. So this is the example that Russell gives in this essay. So Russell cautions against opinions flattering self-esteem. So most men consider themselves or men superior. And many women consider themselves superior. So men consider men superior, women consider women superior. So most people believe their nation is superior to all others. So such opinions only satisfy our self-esteem and it will inflate our ego. So the thought that man is a small being in a small planet is a vast cosmos would sober us and make us humble. So this thought we have to develop. So he wants us to be careful in taking opinions that flatter one's self-esteem. It is very difficult to handle this problem because everybody is conscious of this or her sense of superiority. So according to Russell, this should be tempered with a little modesty and reasonableness. So a standard of values should not be absolute because there are other people and other cultures. So we must learn to respect other people and other cultures. So remaining, we'll see you next class. Thank you.